That thank God for mothers. I want to try that again. Thank God for mothers.
Amen.
Also, I want to also announce that in this church, you can make noise. Noise that is acceptable. The hallelujahs and the amens are for free. If the word of God is coming and it blesses you, you can shout. In this place, there is liberty. So I want you to know that it is nothing unusual when you hear people shouting. In actual fact, when you go to the cemetery, it is dead and silent. But when you go to the maternity ward, there is life. Therefore, there is shouting. And in this place, there is life. So don't think that you are breaking any protocol when you shout. Or you are doing something unusual when you shout. In fact, when you shout, it is acceptable in this place. So I want to say that thank God for mothers. I say thank God for mothers.
Amen.
So we have met today to celebrate the life of the late Mrs. Theodora George. In times like this, people of God, we cast our eyes back in the past to see the good examples and the favorable memories that our mother has gone through. Do we have wish, Sister Gloria, that mommy should have lived longer? We say yes, we would have wished. But we also celebrate God for how many years on earth? 80 years on earth. We say yes. Because people of God, people don't get to 80 years. Last night, our favorite man of DC, Barry Marion, passed away at the age of 77. People of God, he could not clock 80. Therefore, if Sister Gloria, your mother has clocked 80, we say, we thank God for that. You know, you can always, yes, God bless all of you. And you can always look at a glass half full or half empty. Sister Gloria, God bless your mom with children. God bless her with grandchildren. In actual fact, in the last 5 months, you were in London with all your siblings. And most of her grandchildren. You celebrated life with her. I believe that we are thankful to God. People of God, are you understanding me? So we are saying in this to say that we can be thankful to God for his goodness. We can be thankful to God for his kindness. And therefore, we say that God, we thank you. More so, we are in the period of thanksgiving. Don't forget that as long as you remain on this land, you may choose that you are not an American. That is okay. But yes, sir, the period of thanksgiving has boxed you in. And therefore, you must give thanks.
Amen.
If Americans are giving thanks for their forefathers for what they did for them, God bless us all. Amen. God bless the land of America.
Amen.
But we would also want to say that we thank God for God. We thank God for his goodness. We thank God for life. We thank God that he's protected you and protected me. We thank God. In actual fact, some of you are thankful to God for your house. Thankful to God for your car. Thankful to God for your job. Thankful to God for all the things he's done. And I believe that the Latinos are thankful to God for their struggles. And the Africans are thankful to God for their prayers. I want to say that again because it went right over your head. Because last 2 nights, President Obama announced immigration reform. Thank God for the Latinos for their struggles and the Africans for their prayers. Because at a rally of 10,000, you may never see 1% of Africans. It's all Latinos. So the Latinos have struggled and the Africans have prayed and we give glory to God. Ago, I said that if ever I would become the president of America, I would give immigration only to the Latinos. Because it's only the Latinos who fight hard and the Africans are praying. But thank God that I never got there and Obama is there. So we thank God for Africans who
pray,
the Latinos who
fight.
And so we are thankful to God for that. Because that will give opportunity for many more people to have life in America.
Amen.
So that you can come out of the shadows.
Amen.
And as we are thankful to God for all these things, I believe that everyone here can be thankful for a mother.
Yes.
And today I'll give you only 3 reasons why you can be thankful for a mother. Because you see, people of God, mothers are special. The fact that a mother can carry a baby for 9 months in her womb sets her apart from her father. I always say that there are some things that mothers can't understand that fathers will never understand. Thank God for mothers. Sometime this year, I made a statement that scarcely or I've never heard of absentee mothers, but we always hear of absentee fathers. Because mothers are always around. God has created mothers in such a way that they cannot let go. They will always hold on and make sure that there is life for my children.
Amen.
Thank God for mothers.
Amen.
I want to say thank God to my mom, who is not here today in Africa, at the age of 82, crossing into 83, to say that I'm thankful for her life. The fact that she has made me who I am. I may not have known a father for a long time because daddy was not actually home, but mom was always home. Mom will make sure that we get some food to eat. Mom will make sure that we get some clothing to wear. Mom will make sure that we go to school. And mom would make sure that every morning we will read a scripture in the Bible. I'm thankful to God for my mother. I tell somebody, will you shout and say, I'm also thankful to God for my mother. Because mothers are good people. Sister Gloria, I know that you will be thankful to God for your mom. She has passed away. I got to know her for a very short period in her life. Because what I do is that as a pastor, if you are my member, I want to know where you live. I want to know who you are married to. I want to know your children. I want to know where you go to work. I will never, ever, ever forget when I pastored in Virginia that a sister got into trouble. When she went to the police station and it was complicated, one of the policemen said that, go and bring your pastor. But I'll never forget. Go and bring your pastor. So she came and brought me to, was it Alexandria or Dale City, whatever. And I went to the police station. And thank God for pastors. I said that I know her. She's a good lady. Something might have taken place, but officer, she's not like you perceive her. She is a good lady. And based upon my testimony, the sister was set free.
Amen.
I will never also forget when I walked into an immigration office with a church member. They said, go and bring your pastor. The attorney was sitting there. The attorney could not open his mouth to say, there. I went in there. What do you know about this man? I said, he's a good man. People of God, it's good to be a pastor. Who speaks the truth? Who speaks the truth? Because if the guy was not a good guy, I wouldn't even show up. Because I cannot speak anything that is not true. But I spoke well on the person's behalf. And I said to the glory of God that based upon my testimony, he was granted a permanent residency. People of God, I'm saying this to say that mothers are good people. They bring you up in the Lord. The first thing that I want you to understand that you will take away from here is that mothers see the potential in their children.
Amen.
Every mother sees the potential in their children. Why am I saying that? The Bible tells us of a story in Exodus chapter 2. It said that a Levite man went to marry a Levite woman. And they gave birth to a son. And when this son was given birth to, it was during the era where a Pharaoh has passed the law that any male child who is born to the people of Israel should be killed. Because these people are multiplying at a rate that men cannot calculate. The Bible says that the Egyptians had become to be afraid. Why? Because the Israelites were growing at an exponential rate. People of God, I want to prophesy over your life that if the anointing of God is on your life, no matter where you are, you shall grow at an exponential rate. You shall cause a terror to your enemies. So the Bible says that the Pharaoh passed the law and said that if any male child is born within this era, they must be killed. Now, the Bible at this point in time does not mention the name of the father, but the name of the father is Amram, and the name of the mother is Jacobin. These are the parents of Moses. But listen also very carefully that this was not their first child. Moses was their third child. In other words, Miriam had already been born. And Aaron had already been born. But the Bible says in Exodus chapter 2, if you read that, I believe the verse 3, it says that, but the woman saw,
yes, Lord,
that this child is special.
Amen.
I'm talking about mothers. I thought every mom in this place begin to shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen to me carefully, because Miriam had been born, right?
Yes.
Aaron had been born. Now, church, are you talking back to me this morning?
Yes.
Then comes who? Moses. If it was eight, I believe that many children had been killed. I'm talking about mothers who can see a potential in their child.
Hallelujah.
How many of us here can testify that mommy prophesied to me? She sat me down and told me that you are special. She sat to us the glory and said that you are going to marry a man called Jeffrey. He's going to treat you well. He's going to bring you to America. He'll make your skin moist. In your life. So as the baby was lying there, a law has been passed. A decree has been made. Pharaoh was like the president of the United States in our time. He was like the emperor of the Romans in the time of the Romans. When he says yeah, nobody can say anything. When you hear that the Egyptians are coming against you, my goodness, you must run for your life. That was the power in the mouth of Pharaoh. A woman stood up against the authority of Pharaoh. I said that yes, you may have passed a decree, but I see something special in my child. Pharaoh, I will not let Moses be killed. And now what is so interesting is that from that point on, the Bible says nothing about Aaron. It says nothing about the father. I'm not saying that Aaron was a bad father. That's not what I'm saying. But I'm saying that the Bible never mentions death about Aaron. Aaron's name was gone except in Exodus 6:3, when the genealogy was being listed and said that Amram married Jochebed and they had three children. That was it. But when you come to the consistency of childcare, I read something. It says that being a mother is not just childbearing. It is the essence of womanhood. A mother is not just anyone who bears child, but the essence of womanhood is motherhood. In actual fact, there is a saying that says that behind every successful Jeffrey
is
a
Amen.
Because when you continue to hit at it, you will get it. Abraham Lincoln, we all know, tried and tried and tried and tried and tried. Can you just imagine if Nelson Mandela would have said that, I would give up, then there would be no miracle in South Africa. But even when he was in prison, he persisted. But I'm saying this to say that mothers are people who persist. They'll say that I can see a light at the end of the tunnel. I know that God will hear my prayer. So the Bible says that year after year after year after year. If you are here, people of God, I want you to value your mother. Some time back, I preached on a Mother's Day sermon, and I said that call up your mother. You see, people of God, there is nothing like, oh, I don't want to talk to my mom again. Or, oh, because of what my mother has done. You have the ability to forgive and to bless your mother. Because there is a blessing that comes from a mother. That is why today I'm saying that, thank God for mothers. Just let it be a blessing that your mother will be a blessing. So the Bible says that Hannah persisted and persisted and persisted, and one day she enters the temple of God. And I believe that she was like, God, this is it. If you don't bless me, that's it. The Bible said that she began to open her mouth and to pray. And I want to say that the persistency of a mother is the prayer of a mother.
Amen.
When you go to into the African-American circles, they have a saying about their grandmother. And they will say that, my grandmother was praying. I have a praying grandmother. That is a significant statement that I love, because people of God, you may, if you can take everything away from us, let there be a praying mother.
Amen.
Let there be a mother who is what? Who is persistent. Who will mention your name before God. How many mothers have not prayed for their children for a breakthrough on this land? How many mothers have not just cried unto God and said that, God, I want a miracle in my son's or my daughter's life? And I want to say that we thank God for mothers. So number one, mothers can see the potential in their children. Mothers are persistent. And let me say the final one. Mothers are great counselors. Mothers are great counselors. People of God, if I tell you or if I ask you a question, that what do you know about Proverbs chapter 31? Who can talk to me now? The virtuous woman. The virtuous woman. Oh, church, is he right or wrong?
Right.
He's right. Everybody, if you say that, what do you know about Proverbs 31? Everybody will shout and say that word, the virtuous woman. You are correct. I give you a B plus. Yes, it's all that we know. But before the virtuous woman scenario, there is a secret up there. They said that there was a king called Lemuel. And this king became great. Why? Because of the mother. He said that, and the mother spoke into the life of Lemuel this prophecy. My goodness. I'm saying the mothers are great counselors. This mother, before, and we are right, before the virtuous woman could come, there was a mother who was a praying mother. Everybody shout, praying mother. And why? Because mothers are great counselors. And the Bible said that this mother gave counsel to Lemuel before he became great. Before he became a great king and a great man, the Bible says that the mother sat him down. Oh my goodness. I miss those times. Everybody say, miss those times. I miss those times in Africa. Here in America, it is not done. But in Africa, when you are growing up, I don't know about you or how old or young you are, but if you are as old as me, in your mid-centuries, your mother will wake you up early in the morning. Those who are old like me, they are not. If you didn't know, then it means that you are down there. But your mother will wake you up and then sit you down. 4 a.m. when there's no cock crow, and when the world is quiet, and your mother will begin to talk to you. That my son, I love you. I want you to make it in life. Do this, don't do that. Go here, don't go there. And this is why, because mothers are good counselors. I don't know here in America, if you can wake up your son or daughter at 4 a.m. I don't know about that, but the Lord have mercy on all of us. Maybe we need to create another scenario to talk to them. But I'm telling you about mothers who are counselors. People of God, someone said that do not reject the counsel of your mother. There is something about mothers that are good. So the Bible said that Lemuel's mother sits him down and say that you are a king. I'm your mother. I'm not a king. But I want to show you how you can become a great king. People of God, it's not he who is king that is great, but he who surrounds him that makes him great. In other words, David was a mighty man. If you study him very carefully as I bring my sermon to an end, David had men who were around him. A president is great, not because he's great himself, but because he has a great cabinet. The people who advise him. So I'm saying that a mother can see a great potential in you. A mother is persistent, but a mother is also a great counselor. People of God, if you are a mother here, I challenge you as our mama Theodora did. Set Gloria down. And I know that you took the advice. That take good care of your husband. As you are going into marriage, Gloria, I have been there. I married your dad, Captain George of Sierra Leone Police. I know all that history. I have made all my research. Sat you down and said that treat the man well. If you treat the man well, he will bless you. If you are angry with him, cook the food. You just do what you are supposed to do. Jeffrey will come home and say that I'm angry. But although I'm angry, you must still cook the food. No, that's what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is that mothers give good advice. I thought you would say amen to that.
Amen.
They sit their children down. People of God, if you are coming from where we are coming from, don't let us lose our culture.
Amen.
Don't throw your culture away.
Amen.
Mothers, call your daughters.
Yes,
Lord. Call your sons.
Hallelujah.
Sit them down.
Amen. Amen.
Tell them, I love you.
Amen.
You to America.
Amen.
I give birth to you. I love you. And I always am excited when I go for programs like functions in schools and science as STEM programs, and I see the names of Africans. Olujo Wale Bode. What's the name? Sorry, no. The Duncans. I'm excited. Because it tells me that our children are making inroads. The people of God, you all miss that.
Amen.
We are erasing the Jeffersons and the all that, and our names are coming gradually.
Amen.
I say our names are coming gradually.
Amen.
I say our names are coming gradually.
Amen.
Why? Because we need to sit our children down. We need to talk to them as Mama Theodora spoke to Gloria. And so now they cannot even be separated. They are so close. Everywhere you go, I've told them that if you bring your problems to me, I will pray for you. And I'll tell you that I'll go away. Because I know that as for Gloria and Jeffrey, if you put your head in their marriage, you are in trouble.
Amen.
And I said, Pastor, I will pray for you. And I said, I'll go away. Why? Because the mother counseled her very well. So he knows that if we fight small, hey, don't fight, oh, please. That we can reconcile small. Why? Because we thank God for my. I thought you said we thank God for my.
Amen.
So if you are mother in this place, as I bring this sermon to a close, you may be a father, and I've not spoken about you, but take some cue for it. Because today is the day for mothers. But also be a good father. People of God, be a good father. Take charge of your house. Let your children know that God is in charge, number one, but I'm also in charge. Let them love you, but revere you. You know, I've said this before, you know, and my son was, you know, growing up, said that, hey, my daddy is tough. I will never forget that. He is tough, but he loves me.
Amen, amen, amen.
What a difference. You may be a tough mother, but let your daughter or your son know that beyond the toughness, there is love. God bless you, Mama. Let your children understand that we don't hate you. We are directing you. I want to be like the mother of Lemuel. Who sat the king down? He gave him 3 points. I'm not going to go there, but don't chase women, don't drink, drink wine, and don't misbehave, whatever it is. But give him good advice. And then, instantaneously, we roll into the virtuous woman. Amen. That is the secret.
Amen.
Before you can become great, you must listen. And on this day, as we celebrate the memorial service for Mama Theodora George, my prayer is that her good example of raising up 3 children who are all good and stable.
Amen.
Four. Who are good and stable, who have done well. Not only that, but you have grandchildren. May that be an example.
Amen.
May we be able to look at all her life and say that this is a good example that we will leave.
Amen.
Having said all that, Sister Gloria, I want to just speak into your life. I say that it is well with your soul.
Amen.
You see, immediately you began to grow. You begin to grow. Things change. I've come to accept the fact that as I'm growing up, there are some things that I cannot change. People will die in my life. I have to counsel people. I have to be there for people. But in all these things, it does not change the hand of God upon your life.
Amen.
80 years is a good age. In actual fact, Mama had 10 years bonus. Because the normal lifespan of a man, according to most, right, is what?
70.
Yeah, 3 score plus 10 is 70. And the rest is just bonus. He even said that even there, there's trouble. So God looked upon your mom, said Gloria, and added 10. You must be thankful for your mom.
Amen.
You must be thankful
Amen.
For your mom.
Amen.
If you are here like my wife, who have lost their mother as well, and Sister Jellybean, we want to encourage you all that God is still a good God.
Amen.
He's not forgotten about you. I know that you miss your moms, yes, but God is always there. That is the reason why we love God.
Amen.
Because the Bible said that He said that I will never leave you
nor forsake you.
So, people of God, today, don't forget these 3 things.
Yeah.
Number one, mother, that's what?
Potential.
Okay, I'll try that again, church. Number one, mother, that's what? She sees the potential in you. In other words, if you are a mother here, speak good things to your child. You'll become the president of the United States.
Amen.
I dedicated twins of my own, I dedicated my nephews, the children of my sister. And I told them that you guys will grow up and you're going to be senators in North Carolina. I prayed for them and I'm watching because I said it. When you say something, you believe it and it will happen.
Amen.
When your children are growing up, you speak good things because you see the potential in them.
Amen.
Number two, you must be a persistent mother or father. You will not give up. You will struggle and you will make it because God is on your side.
Amen.
Paul says that if God be for us,
who can be against us?
If God be for you,
who can be against us?
And number three is what?
Maybe
give good counsel. Sit your children down. Design your own plan. Don't test them. Don't email them.
Amen.
Speak to them.
Amen.
Words are powerful.
Amen.
And I know that when you do that, God will bless you.
Amen.
Bow down your heads with me.
Amen.
The glory. this place, please close your eyes with me. I want to just throw an invitation right now and say that you may be here. You may never understand or know that there is life for you in Christ Jesus. That the Bible says that he died for you and he died for me. Maybe you are going to church and you call yourself a Christian. But maybe truly you have never ever invited Jesus Christ into your life as your Lord and personal Savior. He's more than a mother. He's more than a father. He's actually the Son of the living God. And so with every head bowed and all eyes closed, if you want to say that, Pastor, I want to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as my personal Savior. I'm not going to tell you to come forward or whatever thing, but I want you to just receive him into your heart that he's your Lord and personal Savior. Amen. If you are in that category with all eyes closed, just stick out your right hand that I can see you and I will pray for you. Because Jesus is passing this way. Jesus is passing this way. Understand that the Lord has marked this calendar on this 23rd day of November, the year of our Lord 2014, to say that you entered into a place called Shekinah Temple. And I, the Lord, I threw the invitation to you. I want you to lay down your sorrows, lay down your shame, lay down your burden, and say that, Father, here am I. If you're also here, you are a mother or a father. You realize that you have gone wrong one way or the other. Wherever you are sitting with all eyes closed, and you want to stick up your hand and say that, Pastor, please pray for me that I'll be able to set my house in order, that I'll be able to be an example to my children and to my family. I would love to pray for you. Close your eyes with me, raise up your right hand. Let me pray for you quickly as we round down our service. God bless you. Close your eyes with me, everybody. This way. Oh, this way. Ah, Jesus. It's passing this way. This prayer after me, and especially for all those who want to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. We are praying together as one body, and please, if you did, you want to see me after the service, I would appreciate it. Say that, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I recognize that I'm a sinner and that I cannot save myself. I bring myself to you and declare that you are my Lord and Savior. I accept you. I receive you into my life. Be my Lord and my personal Savior. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Let me pray for you. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you so very much for all those who are here who now can call themselves children of God. Because the Bible said that as many as believed on him, he gave them the authority, the power to become children of God. And Father, therefore, we receive them into this fold of Christendom and say that your life, which is eternal life, will be their portion in Jesus' name. I pray for mothers in this place and fathers as well. That Father, we thank you for our mothers and our fathers, number one. We thank you for the influences they've had upon our lives. And Father, now I pray, if there's any father in this place, as hands went up, or mother in this place, oh God, who needs your direction and my God, your leading to be able to lead his or her family, I pray that you grant that wisdom. wisdom in the name of Jesus. That God, we shall be examples unto your children and your people, that your name will be glorified. We give you honor and we give you praise in Jesus' mighty name. And the church will shout a big amen. This way. This way. Brother James, Brother Phoebe, are we ready? Brother Michael, are we ready? Mm-hmm. All ready. Okay, if not, then we can do this right now. Sister Lauren, ready? Okay, go ahead.
Good afternoon, everybody. I want to say thank you for coming. On behalf of the family, I want to thank our friends, loved ones, for your prayers and support to us for our loss. A special thanks go to my pastor and members of this church, and also for the Levites and saints of Kingdom Miracle Line for their prayers and support. We thank you and we pray that God will continue to bless you and provide for you. After church, we have reception, and everybody is invited. Thank you once more for your support and your prayers. God bless you.